जय बोलो नित्यानंदा नित्यानंदा विनाशक ये दुखों के सारे। जय बोलो नित्यानंदा नित्यानंदा
भगवान ये है न्यारे हमारे। जय बोलो नित्यानंदा नित्यानंदा
भगवान ये है न्यारे हमारे।
बोलो
जय बोलो
PGR Sindhya from Bangalore speaking. I have been coming to this ashram for last several years, right from the beginning. I have been spending time with Swami Nityananda Ji. I have been knowing Swami Ji very well from almost 16 years. I have been in Karnataka's public life more than 45 years. I have met several spiritual, religious leaders, several Mataadhipatis and all that. And I believe in spirituality. So in the year 2000, it so happened, my wife went into depression for several reasons. So no doubt, we gave her the modern medicine, so many other things and all that. I think it is Chamundi Studios or so. I went and Swamiji healed my wife. We met, both of us, we met Swamiji. We took his blessings. And few more sittings we had. My wife was not in a position at that time to go alone. So we both went together, taken her several times. And she is completely, she was healed. That is one just such thing I am mentioning. After that, subsequently, when this ashram was built, Swamiji came here and several times I have come, I have observed that there is a superpower in Swamiji. That superpower I cannot explain. One can only experience it. So I have no words to explain what exactly is that power. But I can tell that superpower which Swamiji has got, definitely it is a very big thing, not only healing the diseases, but counseling the people, giving them love and affection, building the institutions, it's a very big thing. And I've also read some of the literature which he has produced, some of the finest literature he has produced about spirituality. So, religion is different, spirituality is different, and all the human beings, if they get into some little knowledge of spirituality, things will be different, which Swamiji is doing. I have all appreciation to Swamiji's good work. I seek his blessings all the time.
Once Vakyartha Satya started, whatever doubts I had, I was able to ask, and then I myself came to know that I had clarity about, well, like what I thought I didn't have clarity about, but I now I understand that I have much clarity about things. And now whatever questions I was not able to ask, also now whoever is with me, like in this group, they ask that question, so all my questions, which all my doubts which I had, everything will get clarified, and now I have much more clarity about things.
When I listen to satsang, I have more doubt and questions, but I avoid sharing to others. When Swamiji create this Vakyartha Satya, I have a questions, but somebody will discuss the, in Bharasans will discuss the questions. I clear that questions inside of me. Then I feel complete, and now I avoid having self-doubt, and I try to be compassion with others because of Vakyartha Satya.
See, before doing this Vakyartha Satya, I used to speak many spiritual things which everyone accepts, but I never put it in my action. So whatever I used to tell, they'll never follow it. But after this Vakyartha Satya, when I started applying it When I started applying all the truths in my own life, I started following it. I took more and more responsibilities, and now people around me are getting enriched more. So what I think is, only when you share your experience, only when you give them the visible output, when you follow a practical truth, people will also believe and they'll start following, because this experience is something, a truth that has become a cognition in you.
It started as an understanding, and then that alive feeling happened, that there is something really vibrating inside me, and it's very alive. I keep repeating this word alive, but I don't have any other word for it. But it is the source for all that I do, even my thoughts.
Witnessing space is actually very complete. There is no boundaries. So there is no agitation, there is no frustration, there is none of that feeling there. And that's why it's so inclusive.
Varanasi, Anandavana, the spiritual capital of the world. This city is built out of all our sacred sentiments. This whole city is built not just with mud, stone, wood, mortar. It is built with our sacred sentiments. That is why Ramakrishna says this city is golden city, because all our sacred sentiments are filled and this city is built.